Welcome back. Are you ready to unlock 4 more friends and 3 more buildings today? Day 2 is going to be very important in progressing your archipelago. Manor, archipelago, should I just call it manor from now on? It's an easier word anyway. They don't seem to know what to call any of these things either. Also, just for the sake of clarification, I am primarily using the manor book names for the companions, and I am just going to call Spinda just Spinda. That's how he was introduced to us. I don't know why he has 3 different names throughout the interface. On day 1, we unlocked Candy Sister, Hakiki, and Spinda. If you don't have all 3 unlocked, please refer back to the Let's Start video and see what you may have overlooked. Day 2, we will be introducing Boxy, Lucia, Sofofo, and Mactum. The buildings we are unlocking today are Magic Box, Alert Gondola, and Melting Time. Alert Gondola is what will be helping you start your dispatch. I'll be going over everything I currently know and have confirmed with Dispatch, so please listen through it to avoid possible mistakes. Magic Box will be unlocking items, extra decorations, but most importantly, the gifts you can give to your companions. However, this does go hand in hand with Dispatch. Melting Time will allow you to unlock further drop rate while farming in Komodo, which will help you progress all the manor buildings. So let's get started. Here's some tips to keep in mind when you're starting day 2. If you can, start early. If you want all 4 unlocked on day 2, you will need a minimum of 10 hours before the next daily reset. If you aren't rushing, don't stress about it. You should be farming in Komodo and have some materials available to upgrade buildings. You'll need to prioritize upgrading the Alert Gondola today to be able to send a total of 3 dispatch. You can also unlock a quest with Candy Sister by upgrading the Magic Box twice on one side. All right, let's get this day started so all of these tips make a lot more sense. When you enter the manor on day 2, a new quest will show up where you can meet Foxy and Lucia. Check out their story by clicking Situation when you get nearby. Lucia will leave the conversation, and Foxy is going to continue to talk about wanting to become a merchant. Continue talking to Foxy until the Magic Box Wonder Building is unlocked. Lucia will be available to speak to in the south after the Magic Box is opened. She will discuss some things. Remember to answer not at all at her question. Lucia will then unlock the Alert Gondola. You're going to be excited to send out Spinda finally, but let's go over some very important things about the dispatch system. Dispatch missions take 300 minutes, meaning 5 hours to complete. You will need to log back in to claim the loot and send out the next one if you need to repeat sending out a certain companion. If you want to unlock Mactung on day 2, you will want to upgrade the efficient dispatch. This will allow you to send out 3 dispatches for the day. This means this dispatch count accounts as a daily limit. So even if you unlock other expiration areas, you will still be limited by the amount of dispatches. If you do choose to unlock other dispatch areas, it is necessary to have other manor gear unlocked in order to send out more than 1 at a time. Please remember, you choose who to send out by their profile picture, so try to familiarize yourself with their pictures if you are trying to continue progression or unlock specific gifts. Speaking of gifts, certain companions prefer certain weapons when out on dispatch. You'll be required to have the companion and weapon combinations. While data does support certain companions also prefer certain maps, it's unclear if this is really any necessary for any reason. While we're on the topic of gifts, it's very important to know a couple of things about unlocking gifts. Number 1 is you will get your first one for free. It will be placed in your inventory and you can use it to continue any quests or feel free to gift the recipient. The second thing to know is that the unlock is RNG dependent. You are not guaranteed to unlock the gift item. Trust me, I know. I was pretty annoyed at this revelation too. One good thing though is that sending someone out does not remove them off the manor map. You can still interact with them at any time, although they could be anywhere, unless a quest is available. Then they stay in one place. Now that we've gone over all these notes, let's finally send out Spinda. Spinda will immediately give you a quest to go find Sofofo out in Sweet Dreamfield. Sofofo is stuck in a tree, surrounded by a pack of wolves. Save him in order to recruit him. After inviting him to the manor, you can now finally use him for dispatch. If you have not locked additional dispatch lands, you will have to wait for Spenda to complete his dispatch first. But if you have, you can now send Sofofo out right away. Remember, you do need another weapon unlocked from the Mead Fountain under Weaponry Research. You want to dispatch him twice. You must wait out the initial 5 hours of the first one to complete. But as soon as you send him out on the second mission, a new quest called Mouthless Chef will pop up. You will not have to wait out the time on the second dispatch. Talk to Sofofo right away and head back to Sweet Dreamfield to meet Mactung. Mactung seems to be a soft-spoken little chef who is willing to join the manor if you beat him in a cooking competition. So the way the cooking competition works is there is a random assortment of ingredients available. You must first look at which side is highlighted with the box. It will be highlighted in a yellow. It's possible your side will be highlighted yellow or Mactung's side. Now you are choosing the initial ingredient, but depending on which side is highlighted depends on who is getting the item that you are choosing. So if your side is highlighted, you want to pick the most lucrative condiments and ingredients. And if his side is highlighted, you kind of want to give him anything that will not be in his favor. The recipes are based on the actual cooking recipes that you can unlock in the game for yourself. And I would say you want to do your best to try to shoot for something that's 3-star or higher. So try to be a little familiar with the recipes. Feel free to look up a guide on cooking itself to get a better grasp. Or you could just keep clicking until something works. The initial quest to unlock him gives you unlimited chances to be victorious, and you must eventually be victorious in order to recruit him. This is also another type of challenge that you can do specifically with Mactung daily to increase your affection with him. Once Mactung visits the manor, he finds a lovely spot to make his desserts, and you have now unlocked Melting Time. Melting Time building unlocks the food incentives and nutritional intake. Nutritional intake is for increased dispatch reward, and food incentives is to increase your drop rate, which is pretty high priority. You've just unlocked all the priority buildings and companions for today, but there's still one other task that you're able to do today. You will easily be able to complete after receiving some fantasy crystals as rewards from your dispatched missions from the day. The new arrival side of Magic Box must be upgraded twice in order to progress this part. As soon as it's been upgraded, you will receive a quest to assist Candy Sister. She requires one set of eyedrops to complete the quest from the tab in the Magic Box store. Thanks so much for coming back for day two. I hope this guide served you well. The next few days get a bit muddled with very short tasks, so I will try to compile them together as soon as I can. I was unable to make time to talk more about the Magic Box today, but it basically unlocks items for quests, and it's where you can continue to buy the gifts for our companions after they're unlocked from the dispatch. Well, I hope to see you next time. You're still here? Still here at the end? Oh, did you want to hear the rest of the outro? Okay. To kill everywhere I cry.